Today we discuss the first lesson, reflection of light at curved surfaces. We discuss the first topic, reflection of light by spherical mirrors. So what is spherical mirror? Whose reflection surface is the part of hollow sphere of glass is called spherical mirrors. So here this is the hollow sphere. So the reflection part of the hollow sphere of glass is called spherical mirrors. So generally spherical mirrors are two types. One is the concave mirror and the one is the convex mirror. So what is concave mirror? So concave mirror means, so concave mirror is a part of the spherical mirror. What is concave mirror? So this is the hollow sphere. We cut the sphere from this point to this point, we get this portion. So here the reflecting surface is concave part. So this mirror is called concave mirror. So what is concave mirror? The reflection of light takes place at the concave part is called concave mirrors. And next another one is the convex mirror. So here we cut the sphere from this point to this point, we get this portion. This is the reflected portion. So reflected portion is in convex shape. So this is called convex mirror. So what is convex mirror? The reflection of light takes place at the convex part is called the convex mirrors. So spherical mirrors, the first one is the center of curvature C. So what is center of curvature? So here this is the hollow sphere. The center of the sphere is called center of curvature. So here generally this is the concave mirror. So concave mirror is a part of this sphere. So the center of sphere C, here this is the center of sphere. So this is called the center of curvature C. The center of curvature is represented the letter C. So next term, pole. So what is pole? So pole means the midpoint of the concave mirror. The midpoint of the mirror or the geometrical point of the mirror is called pole. So here this is the concave mirror, this is the midpoint of the mirror. So here this is the P is called pole. Next term, principal axis. The horizontal line pass through the center of curvature to pole. So here the horizontal line pass through the center of curvature to pole is called principal axis. Radius of curvature R. So generally radius of curvature is the radius of the hollow sphere of glass. So this is the radius of curvature. So generally here we see the concave mirror. So the distance between the center of curvature to the pole is also radius of the curvature R. The rays of light parallel to the principal axis incident on the concave mirror, after reflection they meet at a point on the principal axis. That point is called focal point. Generally focal point is denoted capital F. So next term is the focal length. So the distance between the focal point to pole is called focal length. So here this is the focal point F, this is the pole. The distance between the focal point to pole, so this is called focal length. Focal length is generally denoted by small f. Here the radius of curvature is the distance between the center of curvature to pole P. So this is R. So here the focal length F is the distance between the focal point to pole. So don't confuse, here this is the F to P, here this is C to P. The relation between the radius of curvature R is equal to 2F. The relation between the radius of curvature and focal length R is equal to 2F. Generally the radius of curvature is twice of the focal length. So here F is equal to, we write R by 2. The terms of spherical mirror topic is completed.